Yeah, one of my customers sent me a AGBADA jacket, which is the white that I uploaded some times ago. And he requested for the same design, but he wants his own to be a detachable one, that we have another inner. Then I come up with this design. So you can still see that the work is not yet very neat. So because I still want to wash this side, that have a little stain, before finally do the ironing. So on this video, I'll be taking you through the process step by step on how you can draft, cut, and sew this same type of AGBADA design. So if this is the first time you are checking on this channel, you are most welcome to Nobuti Fashion Channel. If you are returning, you are highly welcome back. So without any further delay, let's proceed. So now the first thing here is that I've already started the work already, but I just decided to make the video on it. So assuming that I've not started the work before, I don't need, you won't see this embroidery before finally do the side folding here. But I've already done the design on it, because the work is a little bit an urgent work which I have to deliver on time. If you are on my site, if you are on my WhatsApp status, if you have my contact, you will see this, that I upload this video, the image of this work some days ago. So without any further delay, the first thing you have to do is not to cut the, it's not to do the embroidery on this dress. So what I will now do is to use another material to demonstrate the how you can cut the AGBADA, and then how you can fold it. But I will use the main material to do the final folding. So just spread your material out like this, spread it out in the two layers like this, and then the length of this AGBADA we are sewing, the length is a 40, while the waist, while the sleeve is a 13 inches. So measure 40 in the two places, and then you lay it down like this. So measure 40 inches, then you apply the seaming allowance, which is a 42, that's 40, then this is a 2 inches for folding allowance at the down part of the AGBADA, which will be 2 inches, so making it a 42 inches, so making it 42 inches. Once you fold it like this, then you just cut it out on this edge straight. So just cut it out on the straight. So the next thing we have to do now is to proceed to the folding of the material. So after you have already cut it out, so just notch here. So you notch here, and that will give you the center of the material. So now this is the material. Now after you have cut it out like that, this is what it will give you once you separate it, and you don't need to apply this embroidery yet before do this folding that I'm about to do, to give you, to make it to be very easy. So but if you go, if the reason why that I did embroidery on this one first before do the folding is that I don't want the work to be delayed, because you know how the designer normally behaves sometimes. So I don't want the work to be delayed, so that's why I quickly give it to designer to make the embroidery for me before finally do the folding, to do the final stitches of the dress. So all the two sides of the dress like this, both the upper part and the down part. So make sure that the edge is a round, and then you lay it like this. You can see that design is not making the work to lay. Can see it. So assuming you have not applied this embroidery, once I fold it like that, it will lay properly well. So let me use the back to lay the dress, so that I'll be able to chuck it from the back. So take it like this, take the two down parts together like this, and then you join it together. So you join it together, and then you lay it on the table. So this one this work require mostly of ironing. So it require mostly of ironing. So after you have laid it like this, lay the edge there. After you have laid it like this, let me turn it to the back so that I'll be able to lay that embroidery properly well. So join the two sides like this, and then the next thing to do now is to use a pin to hold both sides, hold the edge here also, and you hold this edge also, then lay it well again, set the edge here as well, and then you apply office pin to the down part also. So you apply office pin to the down part as well. So after we did this, the next thing we have to do is to fold the sleeve. So you know we have to fold the sleeve in the two places. So now after you do that, then you fold the sleeve here. So now let's apply the sleeve measurement. The sleeve measurement is 13 inches. So that is where the wideness of the agbada will end. So but before this 13 inches, we have to have another pleating before the 13 inches. And the gap between the last folding and the 13 inches, I want it to be 2.5 inches. So that is a 2.5 inches. So now what I have to do now is to do the folding. So you mark 13 inches here, and then let's chalk the 2.5, that is the wideness of the sleeve. Then you mark 2.5. So at the down part as well, you mark 13 inches and then the 2.5 also. It's 13 inches and then you mark a 2.5. So after that, you have to notch the down part of the dress. So that 13 inches where we mark that 2.5 and the 10 inches. So that is the point you have to mark now. So just fold it like this. You hold it from this point where we mark that 13 inches and you fold it like this from up to down. So that notching will be where the place that will guide you on the down parts, while the upper parts, the place that will guide you on the upper part will be where we chalk at the upper part. So just fold that place and the 13 inches in which we mark. Then make sure that the material relax very well, both the inner and the outside. Make sure that it's very key, and make sure that it's very laid properly well. So now the next thing to do now is to apply the office pin on it through. Apply office pin on it through. So apply it on the down part as well, like a three places. You apply it here, then you have to apply it as the down part also. So this is just to hold the pleating we folded here. So now the next thing to do is to use office pin. Just pinch my hand there. Okay, you can see that's part of the hazard of our work. Wow. So well, let's continue. So it's meant to happen sometimes. So now let's continue. Then you apply the iron on it. You press it properly well. Make sure that the iron is a little bit hot so that all the gator on the material will come out sharp. So take your time to apply the iron like this. Make sure you press it very well. If you are not using a steam iron, apply a little water on it and then you press it very well. Make sure that the material is properly ironed so that all the gators will come out fine. So apply office pin at the upper part here also. so that you'll be able to use it to hold the material properly well. So now apply the sleeve length now, which is a 13 inches again. That's 13 inches. So apply it at the middle also, which is a 13 inches. So you now add the folding allowance, which we use to fold the inside to the sleeve inside. I'm using a 3 inches for this. So I'm apply 13 inches and you mark 3 inches. So now you take the ruler and you roll it straight down. You take the ruler and roll it straight down. Place the ruler on it and roll it straight. Mark it straight. That is the point where we are to cut now. We can see that that middle is not that straight. So let me confirm this. So now the wideness is 13 plus 3. That's 16 inches. So I think the error is from the marking. So let me mark it again. So that's 13 inches plus 3 inches. So whatever your sleeve length is, so just apply the folding allowance, which is 3 inches. Then you roll it straight down. So what I have to do now is to cut this straight line out. Is to cut it out at this point. And that is it. So this one now has become a waist, which we can use for the kaftan, for the cuff and the likes. So now you mark that 13 inches and you fold it like this. Fold it like this. Make sure that the folding is straight. Then you apply iron, press it very well. If you are not using a steam iron, make sure you spray water on it, and then you apply the iron on the edge and let it relax properly well. So after you do this, the next thing to do now is to remove the office pin and then proceed to the machines. Proceed to the machine and then do the stitches that is needed on the dress. So now remove all the office pin. Remove all the office pin. You can see all the gaiters now. So that is the essence of applying iron on it. So now what we have to do now is to first stitch the first pleating. So lay it like this. Let me lay it like this for you to understand what I'm saying properly. So this sleeve now we fold here to fold on this side, so that then the other one will be inside. So I have to hold this like this now. So I now have to follow all the gaiters that I've ironed out. I have to follow it all through, stitch everything. So this is it. Yep, that is it. So now let's go to the machine and do the stitches. So now you take the material like this, you lay it well. So the first pleating to the side, to the neck now, that is the point we are to hold. So you see it? So you lay it like this from the down parts. That 2.5, which we first folded, that point of a notching, then the second point of a notching as well, that is the place in which you have to stitch. So you stitch it straight down. Make sure that you follow all the gaiters. Assuming if the gaiter is not some side, the gaiter may not show properly well. The gaiter may not show very well. So all you need to do is to be measuring it all through. And to make sure that the line is straight, that is the stitches is straight, so that's 2.5. So stitch it all through. The gaiter on this side is relax properly well, so I don't need to be measuring it. All I have to do is to follow the gaiter straight down. So do the same thing on the other side. Take the point where we notch, that first notching and the second notching which we folded, and I stitch it straight down. I think the gaiter on this side shows very well as well. So stitch it all through. Make sure you follow the line, and wherever that is not showing, just try to apply, just try to measure it with a tape. So please, if you derive any value in this video, and this is the first time you are checking on this channel, please let me hit the subscribe button, and then you turn on your notification bell, so that whenever I drop an amazing video like this again, you will be notified. You can as well check through all other videos in this channel, where I show you the easiest, fastest, and the simplest method on how to achieve anything on the men's dress. There are a lot of amazing videos which you can benefit from this on this channel. Please let me hit the subscribe button to be part of the noble family, and you can as well share and like the video. So this is it. Then the next thing to do is to fold the side also. Stitch the side which we folded as 3 inches, then you fold like 1/2 inch inside, and the remaining one will give you like 2.5 inches. Make sure that you hold the material properly well, and the stitches of the machine is very okay, so that the work will be very neat. So if you have any material, any thread showing from that material, removing from the material, make sure you pull it inside. As I'm pulling this one, make sure you pull it inside so you can see the stitches. So that those are the things that will make your work to look properly well, look professional. So, and if you are stitching it also, make sure you are stitching the tip of the material, not at the middle of the folding. Now make sure you are stitching the middle of the material, and if you want to set the stitches, that is the space of the stitches, don't make it to be too wide, don't make it to be a gather stitches. So those are the things that make your work to come out neat, fine, and clean. So you stitch it all through like this. So those are the things you benefit from being a part of the noble family. All these tips goes a long way to make your work look perfectly well. So do the same thing on the other side also. Stitch it straight down. Make sure you are pulling all the thread that may be showing. Make sure you are pulling it inside like this, and you are folding 1/2 inch. If the stitches you may want to be doing, you notice that it's not straight, make sure you are using a tape rule to check the stitches. But because we have already folded the sleeve and we have ironed it, I don't think you necessarily need to be doing that any longer. That is, if you iron the edge properly well when we are doing the ironing. So you just follow through the gaiter straight down, and this will make your work to be very neat. You can as well apply another material on the side. You can see this thing now. You can see I'm pulling it inside. And then another thing is that draw the damp parts of the material, and you pull the, don't pull the under. You draw the under and you pull the upper parts. So to avoid the folding or rumple of the material. So that is it. The next thing to do is to proceed to the table and do the final ironing. So now this is the work, and this require a lot of patience while ironing. So if you are the type that don't like ironing, you may not find this interesting. So because it require you to iron it properly well all through.
So now, without any further delay, let's get started. So, and please, I implore you, I urge you to watch the process of the ironing, because that will go a long way to make your work to stand out, because this agbada require a lot of patience while ironing. It require a lot of ironing. So let's proceed on the ironing now. So that is all on ironing the back. So the next thing to do now, you can see this thing that I was talking about. So we need to wash that place and then do the final ironing again. So lay it like this and re-iron the side also. You can re-iron the side to make it lay more. So you can see that the work is coming out very neat now and clean. Even a little bit very hard to discover that we stitch the side. So that is the power of ironing. Please don't joke with ironing. It's very, very important in this profession if you want to achieve a great result. So now you can iron the back also. I'm sure you are not getting tired of my ironing. So that is how to achieve a good result on this dress. So ironing. And if you are not using a steam iron, please make sure you apply the pressing cloth on the dress, then you spray water on it before you apply the iron, that is the normal hot iron. So now the next thing to do is to fold the hem of the agbada. So we have to trim out all these rough edge. So if you like, you can as well cuff it with like a 1 inch or half inch. You can cuff the two sides, then you cuff it on the other side as well with like a half inch.
So the next thing to do now is to stitch the hem of the agbada. So now you fold the two sides like this, you turn it to the back and then place it like this. Measure like a 1.5 on this edge and stitch it like a with a like 1.5. Stitch like 1.5. Don't sew it to be too long. Yes, that is it. You can see that it's a 1.5. So now the next thing to do is to do that same thing on the other side, and after we do the same thing on this other side, we will fold the down part, which is the hem, and then do the finishing ironing. So now measure 1.5 here also. Make sure that you set all the pleating underneath very well so that the stitches will not hold any part of it. Stitch 1.5 here also. And that is it. So now you separate the material and you stitch it on the both side, fold here. You fold it very well and then you stitch it all through with you fold like half inch inward. Make sure that you hold the material properly well, and you set the pleating also. Make sure that all the pleatings are facing the right side. Make sure that all the pleatings are facing the right side. You know that you have to set the pleating. Let me set the camera properly. Yes, I hope you can see that clearly now. That is okay. Yep. Then you stitch it all through like this. And then if you want to connect with other great designer, you can as well join our social media and do both Facebook and then Telegram. So that's a novelty fashion, both on Facebook and the Telegram. So make sure you join the group to stay connected with the other great designers. So you turn the side as well like this, and you fold this other side also. Stitch it the same way we stitch the other side. Make sure that you are stitching the tip of the material.
So now you fold the hair also, and then you continue all through like that. Make sure that that folding is well laid and it's not coming out from the, or it's not showing on the front when you get to this edge. Then you close this tip, this edge also, and then that is all. So now let's see the result of what we have been doing since. Wow, can see that. Without, you can see that. That is it. So the next thing to do is to fix the under collar here. You take a material and then you apply a fusing on it and they stitch it under the under this opening. So now this is it. That is the result. And then to achieve, to see the beauty of this dress, you must apply the starch. It's better you apply starch so that this sleeve now will stand. So if you derive any value in this video, please subscribe to this channel till I bring you another amazing video on this channel. I say thank you for watching and remain blessed. Bye.